It's funny you ask that. Sometimes people will walk into my martial arts school, and they may walk in during a time when there's a bunch of ladies out there trying to get in shape, or getting in shape rather, and or they could walk in during a time when there's a bunch of kids on the mat. Both of those programs in my school are very, very popular. They're really successful. But if you walk in during those times, some people may make an assumption that this is not a place that can produce real fighters. If they happen to walk in during my fighter training class, they'd see pretty quickly that we train great competitors. Hard-hitting, effective, winning records, good fighters. We do that all the time. That's part of what I got in the industry to do. Nothing's more exciting, nothing's more purifying than training for and preparing somebody for a fight. But what sets us apart is that my fighters train side by side with everybody else in the school. There's no reason why the athletes can't sit and help support everybody else in the school. There's no reason why the meek and the powerful can't train together. For me, that's part of what a good martial arts community is all about. It's us being together, training together, not being selective. It's not where all the tough guys go over there and all the fitness fanatics go over there and all the moms and the kids go to this school. That's not what this is.